That awkward moment in where you and the President of the United States share common grounds over a particular problem in this country. Stay tuned after this introduction, ladies and gents. What is up, everybody? This is Atticus the Death Meddler, and yes! It is true. Me and the President of the United States, Barack Obama himself, have something in common. That we both are very concerned over the fact that PC dogma and social justice warriorism is plaguing and affecting our college and university campuses. Now, many of you know, and I know a lot of you know this, that I am not a big fan of the president himself. I don't agree with a lot of stuff that he's done. Now, I first didn't disagree with him because I was a raging conservative Republican asshole indoctrinated by my father in Fox News back in the time, but that was a whole nother story. But I still disliked him due to the fact that he went on with promising that he would end Bush's illegal wiretapping programs brought to us by the Patriot Act. But he said he pulled this out of his asshole right here.
I will provide our intelligence and law enforcement agencies with the tools they need to track and take out the terrorists without undermining our Constitution and our freedom. But my assessment and my team's assessment was that they help us prevent terrorist attacks. No more tracking citizens who do nothing more than protest a misguided war. So it's not as if I don't have a personal interest in making sure my privacy is protected. But I know that the people who are involved in these programs, they operate like professionals. In the abstract, you can complain about Big Brother and how this is a potential
as well as using predator drones onto innocent civilians, which that kind of fucking backfired and got a lot of heat after that. Not to mention, and I collabed with Stoutmeister onto this video, and where he asked Congress for $500 million to provide direct military training for the Syrian rebels. And look how well that ended up. We have ISIS, and Europe is under a refugee crisis today. Europe's just looking at us just going, America, what the fuck? But, as much as there is a lot of shit that Obama has done, I could give him a few cookie points over the fact that me and him disagree over the direction that our country is going to with the age of political correctness. I have made countless videos over the PC dogma bullshit that has been plaguing this country, and finally it has spread towards the president, and he decided to speak out on a meeting at a conference at Iowa. And this is what he had to say here. It's not just sometimes folks who are mad that colleges are too liberal that have a problem. Sometimes there are folks on college campuses who are liberal and maybe even agree with me on a bunch of issues, who sometimes aren't listening to the other side. And that's a problem too. I've heard some college campuses where they don't want to have a guest speaker who is too conservative, or they don't want to read a book if it has language that is offensive to African Americans, or somehow sends a demeaning signal towards women. I gotta tell you, I don't agree with that either. I don't agree that you, when you become students at colleges, have to be coddled and protected from different points of view. I think you should be able to, anybody who comes to speak to you and you disagree with, you should have an argument with them. But you shouldn't silence them by saying, you can't come because I'm too sensitive to hear what you have to say. That's not the way that we learned either. And for that, Mr. President, I gotta congratulate you with on that. I gotta congratulate you with on that. Because I mean, it gets pretty sick and tiring of me making these videos addressing the issue. But when the president, like Mr. Obama himself over here, is now addressing it, that goes to show that there is a little bit of hope coming from this country. I just hope for that. Because all these college campuses and universities have been indoctrinated by social justice PC dogma to the point where it even reached Yale University. And I've addressed this issue, and where a Yale University professor decided to not use the word master. If you want to watch the video, I have it down in the description below, or just browse through my videos. It's there. You can check it out. But this is what I'm trying to say here. College campuses and universities have pretty much become the adult daycare centers. These are places and where we're supposed to make future leaders in this country, especially Yale, people that makes careers and stuff. But no, pretty much nowadays you have these safe spaces where these students basically have to, you know, breathe through a bag or do coloring books or watch videos of puppies and kittens. And not to mention there's trigger warnings when you're reading about the Great Gatsby because it seems misogynistic towards women. Pretty much at this very point, like, this was the year in where pretty much we thought we found everything offensive. But oh my gosh, if it was that bad this year, then I fear for many years to come. As I've said this many times before, this is just the tip of the fucking iceberg. Because later then, our bills of rights, the First Amendment, is going to be absolutely obsolete of this point. It's not going to be freedom of speech, it's going to be freedom from speech. Because all that stuff that's going on these college campuses is the death of freedom of speech. You have to realize this, that people have died for this life that we have lived in. People have died for the rights to free speech. There are many countries in the world where they don't have the privileges to freedom of speech or expression. Yes, the First Amendment is a bit flawed because you have these radical organizations like PETA, the Ku Klux Klan, the National Socialist Movement, the Westboro Baptist Church, FEMIN, the Black Panthers. All these organizations are there because of the freedom of speech. But you shouldn't coddle yourself. You should not ban free speech because it's going to make it 10 times worse, and it's going to become a fascist dictatorship that you are trying to bring up, and where freedom of speech is obsolete, where it's technically going to be freedom from speech. And hell, like, there are, of course, I've said this a couple of videos, that, you know, comedians aren't supposed to go to college campuses because they might trigger someone. Now, I know my college isn't like that. I mean, it's pretty awesome, but there has not been anybody that has expressed SJW or PC dogma onto this. And what's really funny is that the simple fact that South Park is addressing this issue as well with its currently new season.
Capiche? You're associating Italian-Americans to intimidation tactics? You better watch your microaggressions, bro!
Okay, look, you don't want to end up like the spokesman for Subway, do you?
Did you just use a term that excludes women from an occupation?
Okay, let's back up. Ah!
Did you just say spokesman instead of spokesperson when women are just as capable of selling sandwiches as anyone? Are you purposefully trying to use words that assert your male privilege?
Oh my gosh, it's just how the PC and salt SJWs want to, like, betray themselves. But yeah, I have to agree with Obama on this. Now, before I end this video, I need to get some stuff out of the way real quick. Things are getting pretty busy at my college. I am almost done. I'm going to be graduating at around spring 2016. And I've been very far behind on the production of my senior project. And I've been neglecting it. I have had 2 incompletes over my work, so I had to fill out 2 contracts. Now, the reason why I'm saying this is because I've been heavily neglecting my senior project due to making these YouTube videos. Now, does this mean that it's going to be the end of Atticus the Death Meddler? Hell fucking no. I'm still going to make videos. I'm just trying to say here that I'm going to be on a break. But don't worry, I've got some very funny stuff coming along the way. I'm going to be making a sort of a creepy slash troll pasta video on the works. I'm also on the works of making a Halloween special. I have been underway doing that. It's going to be coming out this Halloween, so stay tuned for all of that. And no worries, I'm going to be on a little bit of a break. It's just school's been catching up to me, and I've been quite far behind. It's been pretty stressful due to the fact that I've been making these videos for you guys. So I'm going to be on a little bit of a break at this point, but don't worry, I will be back soon, and I will be making a couple videos if I have the time. So there's that. I hope you enjoyed this talk over me and the president over PC Dogma. And I am Atticus the Death Meddler. Hope you like this video. Subscribe to my channel. Links are in the description below. Keep it metal. Have a wonderful day.